This is y axis, this is x axis, okay. This is origin O, and consider another frame STS which is rotating with the velocity of omega. So angular velocity omega. So let's say this is rotating. So okay, this is another frame which is we call STS, which is rotating at a. So this is STS frame, this is S frame, this is Y dash, this is X dash. And the velocity is angular velocity omega. So after t time there, just have the changed position here. Okay, so this is now. This is S frame. Now consider a point P here. Okay, so with respect to our frame, so this is S frame with respect to S frame, okay, and this is given by the position vector R vector, alright, and this is also the same. So the velocity expression, we are so what should be the velocity expression? Now if the particle in frame S, it would be appear be moving with relative linear velocity of minus omega cross v. So if the particle is at rest, then the motion should, because of the motion of this STS frame, it will appear to this observer O at the center that it is moving with a velocity of minus omega cross v, minus because in the opposite direction, because omega is in positive direction, then the omega cross r is actually in the opposite direction, that is the appear velocity at the, so if the particle at, so let's say at when the particle at rest with respect to the S frame in STS frame, in STS frame, the appear like it is moving opposite in opposite direction, that is the velocity must be in opposite direction, that is velocity v in opposite direction. Okay, this is the velocity. Now when the particle is at rest, now when the particle is actually moving in v velocity here, so let's say this particle moving, now let's say the particle moving in v velocity in S frame, I mean the rest frame, then the appeared velocity should be in this frame is going to be equal to, let's say v dash in the STS frame is going to be equal to v, I mean this velocity, that the vector addition of v and minus omega cross v, okay, omega cross r, the vector sum of this. Now this is the expression for the velocity. Okay, now so it is in STS frame. Okay, so let me write here, it is in STS frame and this is in S frame, this is the transformation. Okay, now if I just write it in like this fashion, so d by dt acting on the r is equal to d by dt minus omega, okay, so dr by dt omega cross r. Okay, now what we can do, now it is in S frame, STS frame, and this is in S frame. Now what we're going to do, we actually going to transform this d by dt as an operator. Now if we, what I mean by this, so let's say we just write it like d by dt, just taking as an operator in STS frame, is going to equal to d by dt minus omega cross So omega crossed with something in the left. So in our case, this is when this is there is r, we have here is a r. Okay, now similarly the acceleration in STS frame, that is d square r by dt square, going to be equal to in the same fashion. So the acceleration, that is let's say a in a dash, so let's say a dash in STS frame. Okay, so it is going to be equal to d square r, okay, this is dash, so okay, dt square is going to be equal to what? So we have d by dt minus omega cross, okay, and the same, because we are just doing in this different way, acting on what, the what, so in same minus omega cross, and there is a r, so let's just put the r in the inside this. So we have d by dt minus omega cross and dr by dt minus omega cross r. Okay, now let's just open this bracket. So we have d square r by dt square minus d by dt of omega cross r minus omega cross dr by dt, okay, and minus minus plus, so minus omega, so plus omega cross omega cross omega cross omega cross r. Okay, this is our expression. Now let's just rearrange it. So we have d square r by dt square minus, now by taking the derivative by part, we have omega, so okay, omega cross with dr by dt plus d omega by dt crossed with r in this part, and minus omega cross v plus omega cross r. Okay, now this d square r by d square is actually the acceleration in S frame. Okay, because there is not S anyway. Now omega cross dr by dt is minus omega cross dr by dt is nothing but omega cross dr by dt is the velocity. So we have v in S frame. Okay, this is in S frame. And what is d omega by dt? We are just considering that the rotating frame of reference rotating in a constant angular frequency, that is omega is equal to constant, that implies d omega dt equal to 0, so plus 0 or minus 0, so plus 0 or minus omega cross v plus omega cross r. Okay, and they all have direction because they are vector, or that implies a minus 2 omega cross v plus omega cross r. Alright, now I think I am just done something, maybe some negative sign or positive sign. Okay, PS dash, PS dash, PS dash, everything is right, I believe. Alright, so that implies the a dash acceleration, a dash acceleration is equal to a minus 2 omega cross v plus omega cross r. Now this 2 omega cross b is, so let me multiply this m a here. So multiplying m in both sides, we have m a dash equal to m a minus m 2m omega cross v plus m into omega cross r. Okay, now m a dash is actually nothing but the force f dash, and that is the force acting on the frame of s dash on a particle is actually equal to so f a minus this is called the Coriolis force. So 2m omega cross b, so Coriolis force. Plus the centripetal force. So this is the centripetal part. So centripetal force. Okay. Now this is the fictitious force appeared in a rotating frame of reference. So let me write it in clearly. So Coriolis force. So Coriolis force. Coriolis force on a body, so let's say having mass m, g in a rotating frame of reference is given by 2m omega cross b. Okay, this is the expression for the Coriolis force on a rotating frame of reference. And the centripetal force, centripetal force is equal to m into omega cross r. This is the expression for the centripetal force. Okay, okay,